little bit late. We'll explain later. We're outside. It's a beautiful day in Texas. It's like 75 degrees. Actually, it's warmer outside than it is in our house for some reason. We've had the air conditioner off, but anyway, I also have a new device that Jeff is helping me with. It's called a gimbal. So we'll see how this works out. If you don't know what a gimbal is, just go ahead and, Google it sometime. It just keeps the phone more stable when I'm holding it with my hand. But anyway, we also have all kinds of spooky characters out here that Einstein's not too thrilled with. But Einstein, look who we have. It's Skinny. Okay, I'll get rid of those. He had them last year, but he's not too sure about them. He liked them last year. Eek, eek. Marsha Mouse. And here's Skinny. See, you like Skinny. Boom, 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 boom. Okay, I haven't been able to look at everybody. Hi, Tango. Hi, Connie. KT Spirit. Francis, French Paul. Who else is here? Okay, Jeff just gave me my iPad, so I'm good now. And then it went down. Oh, okay. It's all black, no picture.
How about now?
Okay, guys, how about now? Is there a picture back? Okay, it's back. Okay, I'm sorry about that. I was telling y'all about a hummingbird that is in the shrubbery out just outside the window here. And it's so small that y'all wouldn't be able to see it, but that's what I gasped at. Okay, so, but they're saying it's blurry. Oh, somebody said, it's better now. Okay, sorry. Like I said, we're using a piece of new equipment. Cannot see Einstein very clearly.
Bye-bye.
No, not good picture. Still blurry, says Max the Moluccan. Okay, but Petri says sharp and fine here. Out of focus, says Max the Moluccan. Kay Murphy says everything is fine. Okay, well, we're just, every supernova said same crystal clear. Okay, we're just gonna go with this. Ooh, Einstein, who is that? Who is that? Is that the Grim Squeaker? Is that the Grim Squeaker? Max is still blurry.
It's Max's connection because ours looks fine here.
Okay, Max, it might be your connection. I'm sorry. Okay, Connie says it's still blurry with her, too. Okay, some of y'all say blurry, some says it's fine, so French Paul says push it from 144 to 360 max. That does not make sense to me. Okay, I'm gonna just...
There's nothing we can do, it's...
Yeah. Okay, Arch and Ace, thank you, $5. Okay, all of our super chats go to Parrot Rescue, and that's what I need to do a quick mention about right now. This week, I learned that the Wings of Love Bird Haven is no longer taking any more intakes. They're not taking applications for new intakes of birds. This is because they're in a period of transition. Tango, thank you so much. Leave and come back, it clears up. Okay. Ooh, okay. Anyway, they're in a state of transition. Dee, the director, who has been director for the past 21 years, has decided to step down, and she hired a new director, and that person only lasted 1 month and quit. So she is in the process of looking for a new director. The board of directors is working on that furiously. However, if no director is found by the end of the year, they have made the decision to place all the birds. So that's why they're not taking any new birds in right now. They have about 20 birds available, and then they have about 10 in quarantine, which means they'll be going into the, you know, in with the rest of the flock soon. So they're finding new homes for the birds, and they got several applications that they're looking over. It's always been their goal to place the right bird with the right owner, with the right family, And so, in the meantime, we will press on like we always do with our donations, because they still have mouths or beaks to feed, and they still have costs and utilities to pay and things like that. So we will continue to support them just as always until the end of the year, and then make a decision. But as long as they have birds to feed, I will be supporting them. So Billy says, Marcia, you should apply for the job. I can't, Billy. That rescue, although it's in Texas, it's about an hour and 15 minutes away from my home. I could not live down there full time. I've got too many other responsibilities. Jeff and Einstein. So I just couldn't do that. They need somebody that can live on site, preferably, or live at least close to the facility. Yeah, Tango, I would probably have a stroke. It would just be too much. So, okay. But I was sorry to hear that news, and Jeff is putting a mic on me. Okay. As I said, I was really sorry to hear that news. Okay, so Einstein's happier now. I think the camera's happier now. I'm not. So,
Just make sure everybody can hear you still.
Yeah, can everybody still hear me okay? I'm going to go inside here in a minute, and okay, Tango said loud. Yep. Supernova said loud. Yep. Okay. Okay, everybody can hear me. Oh, Einstein's going to get rid of me too. He just said bye-bye. Okay, Einstein, let's do some talking. What's a dog? What's a dog? Woof, woof. Gonna go inside here. Einstein, what's a dog? Woo-wee, you sure do look pretty. Happy bird?
You all right?
I'm all right. It sounded booming now. Okay, French Paul, I noticed that you said the sound is booming now. So it's definitely better than it was, huh? Thank you all for helping us with these new gadgets and technical stuff.
You all right?
Uh-huh, Einstein. I'm gonna drink some tea. Have some tea? Oh, I thought he would make the drink. Einstein, what colors? What colors? Peek-a-boo. Peek-a-boo. What's a dog? Yeah, talk to Jeff.
You all right?
It's like, give me a kiss. Give me a kiss.
Chastity, I have a link in the description that will tell you, if you go and read it, it'll tell you why Einstein is,
what the dog?
Is picking his feathers.
Wait, wait, wait.
So at the end of this live stream, go and check that out, okay? It's a link to his blog.
Raspberry. Wait, wait, wait. Raspberry.
Raspberries.
Raspberry.
Oh, it's Joanne's birthday. Happy anniversary, Joanne. That's what Max the Moluccan calls birthdays.
Wait, wait, wait.
I think somebody made a typo and said father plucking. Think they meant feather plucking. Oh, Connie, we're missing Mookie, Sue, Doris, and Amanda. I hope they'll come join us later. You all right, Einstein? Einstein, what colors? Getting braver, huh, Einstein? Look here. Look at what's on his swing. Looky there, Einstein. You're getting braver. I'm going to take him down, okay? Come on back. I'm going to take him down. I'll take them down, Einstein. We don't need you to be scared today. Not yet. It's not Halloween yet. We still got plenty of time to be scared, don't we? There you go. All done. No more. All done. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Over here on your swing now. Good boy. Yeah, all better, huh? All better. Hey, you'd be a good bird. You gonna climb up to the ceiling? You gonna climb up to the ceiling? I see what this little device is supposed to do. If Einstein were to climb up to the ceiling, it's supposed to track him. But we don't have that figured out yet. So I don't think it will. Supposed to track him automatically.
Come see me.
You want to come see me? Not yet. Okay. Look, it's such a pretty day. Charge. Okay, Einstein, I'll be right back. Okay. With the dog. No birdie landscape designer for me. I'm not going to be doing that either. I don't have a very green thumb. It either grows or it doesn't. Y'all give Hominy a break. Hominy is alive and well. He's just not here right now. We could go get him though.
Hey Einstein, where's Hominy? You want to get Hominy?
God bless you.
God bless you. Rooster.
Get off the camera.
I don't think he meant to. Einstein flew.
Down.
I think he didn't mean to land there. He just did. Okay, sweetie. Do you want to go inside? He flew off the perch and turned around. Here, this is a screen porch if you're new to watching us. He can't fly away. But he flew to the other side, turned around, and then flew back and landed on the camera just because it was there. But it messed everything up for a minute. That's okay. Do you want to go inside?
Here, let's go inside.
Let's go inside. Okay. We're going to go inside. Hang on. All's better. There. Crazy day. Isn't it a crazy day, Einstein? So crazy. Crazy.
I'm going to try this new device feature again, so we may lose you.
Suffered because we were just changing locations too, but. We're talking. We've got to say something so you'll know that you can hear us. Joanne says it's buffering, but we're back. Tango says we're back. Okay.
Okay. Well, some of the features of the new stabilizer gimbal don't work with
YouTube
Live, but yeah. That's okay.
Yeah. Thanks for being patient with us, guys. Okay, some are saying it's blurry, but some are saying it's loud and clear. So, you might be having some blurriness or some connection problems because we moved, and that might clear up here in a minute.
Or do you like? Somebody said log out, log back in, because the picture is clear there.
Yeah, just log out and log back in. Okay, so, again, thanks for your patience. We're going to see if Einstein has anything to say. Einstein, are you want to get in any trouble? You know what he was doing the other day? Last night he had his turtle in the water, and he was holding it up with his foot, and it was dripping like it does when I hold it up again, you know, above his head, and he was going, water, water. So, and then he was playing with it for a long time in the water. So he was really having a good time with it. I got a little bit of video of that, but, and Einstein's got a new friend too. You got a new friend. Let me see, did it move? Oh, we got a super chat. Thank you, Tony Smith, $5. I can smell those wet feathers. I know the smell. Oh, isn't it a wonderful smell, Tony? I wish I had perfume that smelled like it. Yeah, it's great smell. Thank you so much. Okay, Einstein, look here.
Sorry.
Okay, come on, get down. Looky here. Look at Mr. Caterpillar. You got Mr. Caterpillar. Want to get down? Good boy.
Look, Mary Hebert sent $5 too.
Thank you, Mary. Looky there. Looky there. Our friend Liz sent the caterpillar. Almost said helicopter. Oh, brother. So thank you, Liz, for the beautiful, beautiful caterpillar. Whee! It's orange and yellow, green, blue, and purple. Do you want to play with it, Einstein? You were playing with it before. Come on, look. Oh, I don't know if Einstein's going to do the fireman slide. We can hope. Okay, Einstein, we'll see you in a little bit, okay? Where I'm going here. We'll be back. We'll be back.
See you later.
Einstein, what's a turkey? That's a dog. What's a rooster?
Let's move the caterpillar. Here we go. Up, 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 up. Good boy. Want to make some real noise?
Einstein. He took down Maisie again.
Let me see, you grab the camera. Sure, grab the camera.
Okay. Okay, that's not fun. That's not nice, is it, Einstein? He's on the... You love Maisie. What's the matter, sweetie?
Woof woof. Woof woof.
Okay. Maisie's dead.
Here we go. Let's go to the condo. Let's go to the condo.
Okay, French Paul just asked, and I don't know if it was a rhetorical question or not, but anyway, he asked, do macaws talk very well normally? And they're not great talkers. They do talk, but they don't talk very clearly. I've never known a macaw that talked clearly. So, you know, they'll say things like hello and goodbye and things like that, but they don't talk like, well, I guess like what African Greys, how African Greys talk. And that's fresh water Einstein has in his pool, so we keep it cleaned up pretty good. But he was thirsty. He just had lunch before we started the stream, but I guess he didn't get any water. You thirsty, sweetie? You want to play with some water toys? He's not very talkative today. Let's play with some water toys. You want to play with your turtle? Let me get your turtle. Want to play with your turtle? Here, I get it. Here you go. You like Mr. Turtle. Come over here. Woo! Get your turtle. Get your turtle. Get it. Get it. I'll get it.
Some water?
Some water, yeah. You love Mr. Turtle. Get it, Einstein.
Watch the comments and I'll play with him.
All right.
What the whale?
the matter, Einstein? Jeff and Einstein are having a good game of toy toss. Who's going to pick all this up?
Martian mouse.
Eek, eek.
Ouch.
See what I have to put up with all the time? And then I wonder why I don't get any work done. The house is a mess. Oh, by the way, the calendar is coming along, but it will be towards the end of the month. It'll still be a while. But I think y'all will like it when it gets finished. I think everybody will enjoy it. I hope so anyway. And it's going to be sold by a different company. Not Barney, but... Barney. Gosh. Barney the Moluccan. He's come out with a calendar, so I'm going to use the company that he uses. I went and checked it out, and it looks like a pretty good outfit. So he steered me to that company. Oh, Einstein, did Jeff wear you out? Okay, Einstein, what colors? What colors are that caterpillar? Einstein, what's for lunch? What's for lunch, sweetie?
See you later.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
Lydia, yes, the calendar will be available to be shipped overseas. Might cost a little more, but because it is an American company that prints them.
Here, I'm sorry. Let's clean this mess up.
He didn't want Jeff cleaning it up.
Squirrel.
Good boy. What's a dog? What's a dog? They're pretty, but what do they say? What's water? What's water?
Squirrel.
That's right, good boy. We just tuckered you out, didn't we?
I got clean.
Einstein, come here. Up, come see me.
One Lump 21 just asked, what do we do if Einstein gets bored with something we're saying? Well, we don't really know if he gets bored with it. He won't let us know, but he just stops saying it. But the funny thing is, he'll stop saying it, and then all of a sudden he'll, maybe a year later, or it just varies, but he'll start saying it again. For example, he stopped saying red butt chicken. And well, recently he's been saying red butt chicken again. Hi, Einstein. What's red butt? Red butt chicken? He probably won't say it now because he's really not in the mood to say anything right now, unfortunately. And he just had lunch, so he's not very food motivated. And he's a little sleepy probably. And then every time usually right before Thanksgiving, he'll start saying Merry Corn, which is our holiday greeting. And that's something he came up with several years ago. And he hadn't been saying it yet, but because I just mentioned it, he might start saying it now. Not now, but in the next few weeks. Because it's almost Merry Corn time, huh, Einstein? Merry Corn. Ho, ho, ho. What does Santa say? He did ask me that about a month ago. He said, what does Santa say? Oh, that really surprised me because we hadn't even been talking about Christmas or Santa or anything. But right now he's looking at me like he's interested in what I've been saying. Are you interested, Einstein, in Merry Corn? Merry Corn. Ho, ho, ho. So you never know what he's going to say. Happy New Year. He doesn't say Happy New Year. He says Happy Year. You're going to sleep, aren't you, sweetie? Yeah, you're going to sleep. Okay, we want to thank you all for being with us and for being so patient with the stream. Jeff is doing something now that I don't know what he's doing, but it's like bouncing around.
Yeah, I was just okay. Tripod lowering.
Oh, okay. We're going to let you all go and get on with your week and your day, what's left of it. I know some of you that's over, and y'all are probably wee hours of Monday. Yes, he's a very sleepy red butt chicken. He didn't say very much, but we had a lot going on. Jeff was with us most of the stream this time, which is unusual. He really didn't want to be outside, I don't think. Now he just wants to take a little nap after lunch. So y'all be good. Be good to one another. Stay safe. And we'll see y'all again next week, okay? Thank you all. We love you. Bye-bye.